The Ministry of Finance has proposed amendments in the Excise Duty Amendment Bill 2022 to increase excise duty on imported spirits from 80% to 100% or 2,500 shillings per litre, whichever is higher, of alcoholic strength by volume less than 80%. But Uganda Manufacturers Association members want the rate maintained at 80%. Daniel Birungi, the executive director, Uganda Manufacturers Association, defended the position, arguing that in addition to the COVID-19 pandemic, the alcohol industry is currently grappling with an unprecedented increase in illicit alcohol production.
This increment in tax only serves to punish the formal sector and drive the informal sector more into closing out the business opportunities available. Remember, the formal sector pays taxes and is visible. The informal sector is not.
I want to ask you, come here and say we should not exempt, we should not tax heavily on spirits imported, because the local people are out competing importers. We are on the side of the local people. So for my humble view, I've listened carefully, sir, and very, very strong case made by two of them are my OBs from, they are my allies elsewhere. But on this one, sir, I think this year permit this country to not exempt. We all advance money for comprehensive review, and we believe it's high time we've lifted most of the incentives to leverage our revenue. Efficiency is the lowest in the region. We are at 12.8%. The region is at 16.
The manufacturers also asked Parliament to lower the threshold for local investors to benefit from income tax exemption from the proposed $5 million to $2 million for local investors and $35 million to $10 million for foreign investors in order to boost investments.
We believe that tax policy and tax law must resonate with the environment in which the taxes are to be administered. As such, our proposal on this is that the thresholds must be lowered a bit further.
However, the proposal received mixed reactions from lawmakers like Mwanga Kivumbi, Butambala County, and Nandala Mafabi, who questioned why the manufacturers are only asking for exemptions and none is making proposals on how to raise government revenue. They pointed out that currently Uganda is losing 7.7 trillion Uganda shillings in tax exemptions, which are not yielding tangible benefits to the economy.
Here and make a proposal how to raise government revenue. We all know the argument is for incentives, but there is a country to run. We all need, and the argument comes through, give us all manner of incentives. Let me maybe also throw them to a general discussion. We are exempting 7.7 trillion shillings as of this year's budget in exemptions. Consequent of that, we have a debt rollover, which is debt refinancing, of 8 trillion, for which consequently we pay interests of nearly here and make a proposal how to raise government revenue. We all know the argument is for incentives, but there is a country to run. We all need, and the argument comes through, give us all manner of incentives. Let me maybe also throw them to a general discussion. We are exempting 7.7 trillion shillings as of this year's budget in exemptions.
Committee members accuse manufacturers of causing the current crisis of the skyrocketing prices of essential commodities by repackaging imported finished goods and disguising them as locally made goods, which has frustrated local production.
That's why the products like cement are going up. 90% of the raw material in cement is not a raw material, it's called clinker, which is imported. The stones from Karamoja, the water we give for free, the electricity is being used for them to come and pack their clinker in cement. That soap you see here is just being brought a finished product, then they put in drum to cut. That cook
very manufacturers. Let me use a quick example, Mr. Chair. Sugar industry. Sugar, they manufacture sugar. I don't know all the inputs. But at least one of the things I know is that the manufacturers of sugar grow sugar cane.
Deo Kayemba, the chairperson of Uganda Manufacturers Association, however, fired back at the members of parliament, arguing that government hasn't supported local manufacturers by delaying to clear its domestic debt obligation to the private sector, which is becoming unsustainable.
Domestic debt. Many of our businesses have supplied the government, and they have not been paid for a long time. The domestic debt has remained at an unsustainably high level. But all is not lost. We have you, our representatives, and the custodian of the law.
Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.